Genesis 33. Later that day, Jacob met Esau coming with his 400 men. So Jacob had his children walk with their mothers. The two servant women, Zilpah and Bilhah, together with their children went first, followed by Leah and her children, then by Rachel and Joseph. Jacob himself walked in front of them all, bowing to the ground 7 times as he came near his brother. But Esau ran toward Jacob and hugged and kissed him. Then the two brothers started crying. When Esau noticed the women and children, he asked,
"Whose children are these?"
Jacob answered,
"These are the ones the Lord has been kind enough to give to me, your servant."
Then the two servant women and their children came and bowed down to Esau. Next, Leah and her children came and bowed down. Finally, Joseph and Rachel also came and bowed down. Esau asked Jacob,
"What did you mean by these herds I met along the road?"
"Master,"
Jacob answered,
"I sent them so that you would be friendly to me."
"But brother, I already have plenty,"
Esau replied.
"Keep them for yourself."
"No,"
Jacob said.
"Please accept these gifts as a sign of your friendship for me. When you welcomed me and I saw your face, it was like seeing the face of God. Please accept these gifts I brought to you. God has been good to me, and I have everything I need."
Jacob kept insisting until Esau accepted the gifts.
"Let's get ready to travel,"
Esau said.
"I'll go along with you."
But Jacob answered,
"Master, you know traveling is hard on children, and I have to look after the sheep and goats that are nursing their young. If my animals travel too much in one day, they will all die. Why don't you go on ahead and let me travel along slowly with the children, the herds and the flocks? We can meet again in the country of Edom."
Esau replied,
"Let me leave some of my men with you."
"You don't have to do that,"
Jacob answered.
"I am happy simply knowing that you are friendly to me."
So Esau left for Edom. But Jacob went to Succoth, where he built a house for himself and set up shelters for his animals. That's why the place is called Succoth. After leaving northern Syria, Jacob arrived safely at Shechem in Canaan and set up camp outside the city. The land where he camped was owned by the descendants of Hamor, the father of Shechem. So Jacob paid them 100 pieces of silver for the property. Then he set up his tents and built an altar there to honor the God of Israel.